Good morning, class. We've learned quite a bit about cancer and how it can develop in the body. Today, we are joined by a specialist in artificial intelligence who will be speaking about how AI is being used to accelerate cancer research and therapy.
Hello, everyone. I'm excited to be here. Before we begin, let's recap what cancer is. Are there any student volunteers who would like to explain what you've learned so far?
Sure, I'd like to. Cancer is a disease in which some of the body's cells begin to grow uncontrollably. Normally, human cells grow and multiply through a process called cell division. When cells grow old or become damaged, they die and new cells can take their place. Sometimes this orderly process is disturbed and abnormal or damaged cells grow and multiply when they shouldn't. These cells form what we call tumors or lumps of damaged tissues.
Yes, great explanation. So tumors can be of two types, malignant or benign. Malignant tumors can spread across the body and form new tumors through a process called metastasis. Benign tumors stay in one place and cannot invade nearby tissues. Benign tumors are generally larger in size.
But how do cells get damaged in the first place? Changes in the DNA, called mutations, can result in damaged cells. This may be a result of errors during the DNA replication process of cell division, or it may be triggered by harmful substances, such as the chemicals in tobacco, or UV rays from the sun.
Cancer treatment involves locating the tumor, determining what type of cancer it is, and then choosing a course of therapy to get rid of the tumor. Now let's talk about artificial intelligence, which is also known as AI. AI systems are computer performance tasks that use algorithms to mimic a human's cognitive ability. In order to develop these systems, it requires a large amount of data sets, which allows the AI to find out the pattern within the data set to identify the relationship between complex features in the data.
Oh, that's so cool. So how could AI be used in the context of cancer?
Well, you see, AI could be applied to many areas of cancer research and therapy. One important use is in cancer detection. When testing for cancer, imaging tests such as CT scans, MRIs, or X-rays are taken to produce detailed images of the area where a tumor may have formed. Traditionally, radiologists individually inspect each image to look for tumors. Now we can train AI technology to analyze these images and detect cancer.
Whoa, that's really cool. But why might we use AI to detect cancer when we already have radiologists who are trained to interpret medical images?
Great question. So the goal of using AI to detect cancer is not about replacing the jobs of radiologists, but rather aiding them in establishing quicker and more accurate diagnoses, because we know that when cancers are found early, the prognosis is often much better for patients. Even the most experienced clinicians make errors because the human eye is not perfect. AI has the potential to be extremely accurate. For example, due to the power of deep learning, a system was found to be over 90% effective at detecting lung cancer spots. For comparison, radiologists typically average a 65% accuracy.
That's amazing. Are there any cases where a radiologist's expertise might be more helpful, though?
Absolutely. Since AI systems look for patterns based on the data sets that they are trained against, these systems are best at flagging the common, or what we call textbook, cancer cases. One commentary highlights that human radiologists can more accurately diagnose the more complex or unusual cancer cases. Now, this is likely due to critical reasoning skills and adaptability that can't quite be mimicked by AI just yet. Since thousands of cancer screening tests are initiated each year, it places a lot of burden on radiologists. AI could be used to flag the common cases, allowing radiologists more time and resources to focus on the more complex cases.
Interesting. Can AI differentiate between different types of cancers?
Yes, it can actually. So once the tumor has been located, we can take a closer look at the microenvironment and determine what type of cancer it is. AI technology can make use of deep learning pattern recognition to quickly scan through thousands of images and detect critical regions. These can help it determine the exact type of cancer at a much faster rate than ever before.
Wow, that's impressive. Can AI also figure out the exact mutation that occurred to cause cancer?
Yes, so this is typically done by genome sequencing, which determines the exact sequence of DNA nucleotides in the genome. AI can speed up this process by integrating this information with the processes in the cell to get a holistic understanding of the mutated genes. For example, in one study, researchers trained AI technology to classify lung cancer images as either having adenocarcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma, or normal tissue. It was able to do this with a 97% accuracy. It was also able to identify six of the most common genetic mutations, all within a 64% to 86% accuracy.
Wow, that's very cool. I'm curious to know if AI can also pick up on other information from the images.
Good question. So AI can be used to characterize the tumor's microenvironment. This is made up of the tumor cells, nearby cells, extracellular matrix, and interstitial fluid. These can all interact with the tumor cells, influence their phenotype, as well as determine how the tumor will evolve, move, or respond to therapies. Using this information, AI can help oncologists predict outcomes for various types of cancer therapy and make informed decisions on next steps for therapy and further analysis. This technology is evolving rapidly. Scientists are working on developing more powerful, multiplexed imaging platforms which are capable of detecting many aspects of the cell microenvironment at a much greater resolution, which will allow researchers to study complex cell-to-cell interactions in much more detail and at faster rates.
Can you tell us more about some of the ethical considerations we need to consider when implementing AI into healthcare settings?
There are absolutely ethical considerations to take into account. The first is confidentiality and consent. Deep learning requires a large amount of confidential health data. It is extremely difficult to get every individual's consent to share their health records for the development of AI. Another ethical consideration includes bias and transferability in AI. As previously mentioned, AI is a learning system based on a massive data set to develop its ability. However, it is well recognized that many of our datasets do not adequately represent diverse groups. Images taken from a very specific group in a very specific setting may not necessarily be representative of all demographics.
Interesting. These all sound like very valid concerns that may be hard to find solutions for.
Yes, engineers and policy workers are working to minimize the potential downsides of the technology before it's widely available for use.
All right, class, that brings us to the end of this presentation. We've certainly learned quite a bit today, and we're excited to see where artificial intelligence will take us in the future. Thank you for sharing your knowledge and insight with us.
It was my pleasure. Now, from one scientist to another, continue to stay curious and ask questions. Created using Powtoon.